other access to these topics from our paper with APAS series. And yeah, it gives some this introduction to the monster algebra is, yeah, as you say, this, well, I consider the set of 2A, 2A, to a involution. Yeah, so that was a very appropriate question of Akihiro. So what is the rank of the corresponding graph? So we can see the graph on 2A involution. And they form the class of six transpositions. In a sense that if you multiply two involutions from the class, you obtain the element whose order is it more six. When you multiply the and this product really belongs to one of nine conjugacy classes that was written here. So it can either be identity, in which case the involutions are equal, and then it can be 2A, so these two involutions are adjacent, and then it can be 2B, 3A, 3C, it can be 2B, 3A, 4A, 5A, 6A. Right, so that's the, this is very remarkable association schemes of rank 9, but it is commutative, and the minimal eigenpolar is, well, not trivial, eigenpolar has these frameworks. Dimension 196884. Right. Right. I think what I always feel this is 196883. Appears as a as an irreducible component of the definition of action for the monster, and by some reason, well, Conway found it's more convenient, and well, in fact, more convenient to add one more dimension, so to consider a 196883 dimensional, to add one more dimension here. And see what will happen here on this vector space. Well, you have an inner product and an algebra product. How would I say? Well, the way you add this one dimension and the way you add one dimension in the permutation is not the same. Yeah? So this is not this one dimension, but in a sense that the inner product and the algebra product are scaled in a different way. So I can explain that, well, on the permutational module, you have a usual product, which is the Hadamard product. And this product you project on every irreducible. And then you can take this sum of 1 for plus this product, and you can restrict this product, reduce this product to this sum of irreducibles. But this is not the only invariant product. You can rescale it in different way, independently. And the way it is rescaled here is different. right. But in any way, in this space, well, every vector or this vector space. So if you take tau, basically enough tau to add involution, you have a, it has a projection into this vector space, which you call A of tau. Right, so and then yeah, so that will be a specific vector in this vector space. And we, this is the vector we call the Majorana action. Majorana axis. You see, I just want to expose once again this analogy. So you take the algebra of that an minus 1, so this is the constant group isomorphic to the symmetry group. And then you can realize it by reflection. So you have 1, 2, to free this transposition. And how you make it? So you start with the upper normal basis. So bi, well, if you take a vector space, bi, bj is delta ij. So you take a basis and take the inner product, so this will be upper normal basis. So then you take the transposition, you transposition, say, I plus 1 from a general ij, and what you associate to this is the following vector. So this would be I minus, say, b I plus 1. Right, so you have this situation, you associate the vector in this space. So, this, you see this, you have some analogy here. And then on this vector space, you get this vector space is double, which is span of B1 up to Bn. So this symmetric group acts. So how is transposition tau? How is transposition acts on this space? Well, you know how it is. So this is, well, this is called this, say, root. So you take this root and apply it to the vector, which goes in the following way. So we notice that the V minus what is it? So you take the V tends to R times R divided by 2. Anyway, so this the idea, you take R, this R is reflected by minus R by the corresponding tau, and already this is perpendicular to the state by themselves. So what is, we see this with this point, we take the evolution, realizing it in this vector space. And now what we would like to see is just looking at this vector space with this vector A of tau, we would like to reconstruct the action on tau on this space, studied from this A of tau, as we have done in the reflection group. In the reflection group, the idea was really easy. So it's something like this tau, like this R, created back to its inverse, as you think, perpendicular stays the same. And yeah, so it turns out to be possible in this monster algebra, but in order to recover this involution tau from the corresponding projective the image, you need not only the inner product but the algebra. So, and then this is the way it works. So we have this this axiom M1 and M2, which actually, well, M1 axiomatize the symmetric bilinear form and bilinear commutative but non-associative algebra product on the B. And M2 is M2 is specified some Norton inequality of which at some stage we believe will play a very important role in this theory. And I think the importance of this Norton inequality is the following. So we A1 dimension and rescale the inner product, but we rescale it in such a way that the inner product of any two Majorana axes become non-negative. And that's somehow hidden in the Norton inequality. Anyway, so that's the real axioms come from M3. So M3 basically says that it is of length 1, this is idempotent. Alright, so the length 1 is really the way how we rescale the inner product. This is our this to our rescaling the inner product. The important part really come from M4, which really says that if you consider the adjoint action on this Majorana axis, so you have this we have this algebra product. We know how to multiply any vector by A of tau. Take a linear transformation, so you take the A of tau and then apply it to V, and the vector product of A of tau times V is algebra product, which is commutative, and this is what is called, say, a joint action. And so this apparatus really have three eigenvalues, eigenvalue 1, eigenvalue 0, eigenvalue 1, 4, and eigenvalue 1 over 32. The whole vector space really splits into the direct sum of these three spaces. And then I write A, or this is another A of tau. Right, so we have this decomposition. Yeah, so this is come from the algebra product. But now, how we reconstruct this tau back for this action? And we reconstruct it in the following way. So x is 1 plus 1 on these four subspaces. On these subspaces, x is minus 1. So it's invert minus 1 over 32 eigenspace for this vector. Anyway, so that's the way how this reconstruct the involution works. So to reconstruct it, not unlike the reflection group, you need more than just the inner product. Because this A itself really sitting in this subspace, so this one eigenspace is in fact spanned by A, and this is one of the axioms, I don't know, it's axiom 5. There's the, but A is idempotent itself, so it is for its adjoint action, it is one eigenvector, and all other one eigenvector, a linear combination of that. Okay, so that's the way, yeah, so this is the axiom 8 and 6, which really says, well, in sort of analytic way, how you recover this involution tau. I must say that if you take the viewpoint on that it's apparatus algebra, then this tau of A will be the near model involution. And that is Majorana axis will be down on the Eisenberg vector in there. So the scale. Right. So, but what is really special about this, what happens about this corner, is that with this involution you can associate another partial automorphism. So, if you take this involution tau, then it centralizes the eigenspaces of A with eigenvalues 1, 0, and 1, 4. And then you can, well, it really comes to an involution sigma, but it doesn't have to, anything to do with the sigma. it was to be involution last time. And this sigma, well, it actually is not defined here. It's not defined how this, so this is not a linear transformation of the whole space. On the 132, it is not defined. But on this part, it adds plus one, and minus one here. So it invents the eigenspace with eigenvalue 1, 4. Yeah, so this is axiom M7. And, well, this M7 really comes to, these axioms imply the fusion rule. And the fusion rule, the fusion rule, as they written here, really says the following. If you take the eigenspace alpha, eigenspace beta, then you can decompose it two eigenspaces, and then you intersect it to the third eigenspace. So sometimes it will be zero for some alpha, beta, and gamma. So sometimes you multiply two eigenspaces, and you obtain. Oh, sorry, it should be gamma. Then you never obtain an element from the third eigenspace. And what is written here is just the cases where these triple can be non-zero. For instance, if you say multiply one eigenspace by 1 over 32 eigenspace, the product will lie in 132 eigenspace. And this is really easy because it just says that 1 plus times minus 1 is minus 1. So if you take the eigenvector, let's say x is minus 1, plus 1 is minus 1, and minus 1 times minus 1 will be 1. So that's why on this corner you don't have 1 over 32. So these rows and the columns, the last column and the last row, really are equivalent with the fact that the tau is an isomorphism of the algebra, and the inner quadrangle really reflects this sigma symmetry. An essential part is if you take 1 over 4 eigenvalue and multiply by 1 over 4, you will never get 1 over 4. So you get 0 or 1. Alright, so these are the axioms, and well, this is the table which in physics known as a fusion rule of Virasoro algebra with central part, with central shell in one half. Anyway, so there are many names, and right, so we just call it the Majorana properties. And yeah, so if someone wants to check the traces for this name to Majorana, so we just use good words. Alright, but I think what is really remarkable that these properties, which has two forms, first they can be drawn as a symmetries or partial symmetry of the exponent, or as fusional, which are in fact equivalent, but surprisingly, to a great surprise, leads to something that you can describe the algebras, sets of algebras in these. So, what is really done by a theorem of Sakuma is the following. So you take two equations, say tau 1 and tau 2, so that when you multiply it, you end up in a class, you end up in one of the classes which are in the left column of this table. So this is one of the classes, sorry, I don't know if it's 2a or class k, and then k belongs to this, I don't know, this is 1a, 2a, and so on, they all together, 9 classes, and it is by 6a. Then, well, you map this tau into this algebra, so you have a of tau 1, a of tau 2, and you can see that the subalgebra generated by these two axes. It turns out that, well, I think a priori you can expect anything from each algebra can help you. But it turns out that, well, in all cases, is at most 8-dimensional and has this very explicit form. You see, the structure of the algebra is deduced by Sakuma, exclusively from the axioms of this, what we call this Majorana axiom, but essentially from the fusion rule in this algebra, and without any explicit reference for the monster. And it turns out that they are very exactly as in the monster rule. Yeah, so these axioms, well, essentially, they are written now with tau and sigma, well, specify the two generated subalgebras in the Majorana algebra, which was the beginning of the story. So the way how the algebras are written, I know you have to. Anyway, so this is explicit form. So then, of the algebra, written in particular bases. So when you multiply two evolutions, you obtain diagonal group. Well, it contains one evolution. Some of them are also of type 2a. They also correspond to vectors. They correspond to what is AA. But for some algebra, you obtain additional elements. Right, so that's what, it's a remarkable Sakuma's theorem. So it's the theorem of Sakuma, dated in 2007. So actually, it improved in terms of Bragg's apparatus, algebras, and in terms of eigenvector. But remarkably enough, all what is involved in this. Some finite dimensional things, and all you need is these fusion rules of these algebras. And I think this was somehow the turning point, but this in the way how I looked at this monster algebra. So my hope was to make it useful, the simple connectedness of the geometry for the monster, or general ability of the monster graph. But it turns out that much more is standing behind all this. And right, and well, if we look back to the to the Coxeter group, so on one hand, I wanted a simple laced diagram, but among the finite Coxeter group, well, there is also a group of this type, which is S4, a group of this type, which is a group F5, or 2.
Basically, you have four choices
But right, and this was the result which we have told with Appas Savage. Let's say there are four choices. So, 2a, 3a, 2a, 3c, 2b, 3a, and 2b, 3c. Right. So, what happens and what is not expected for each of these four choices, the algebra is in fact uniquely determined just by the axiom, by the axioms, which is actually were fusionable. The algebra is uniquely determined, and it is isomorphic to the correspondence of algebra monster. What is probably said here that about classes of A5 subgroups in the monster. Well, I think at least what is stated here, well, it describes the classes of A5 subgroups in the monster containing the class 2A. Is it two classes? Anyway, so it turns out to be the perfect corresponding to the subgroups of the monster, subalgebras in the monster, the five subgroups in the monster. And the dimensions are the following. So that's the dimension is 26, 29, 20, and 45. So this part was done by Akademgorodok. After series of myself, I think it's included this part. And I think this was done by after series, Symmetries, Spectra, and I don't think that they get it published, but it's kind of completed. So this sort of result really demonstrates some behavior similar to Witt's theorem. So we have it, say, some Majorana algebra. Algebra. What is this? So this is a vector space within the polar. And there's some special vectors which Majorana axes are located. And then you take a small part of this, just generated by three of them, entities with this particular order of the polar. And their structures are uniquely determined by the algebra generated by the pairs, and uniquely fit inside the monster. Right. I think I'm just adding to the done for alternating group of degree 5, and there is ongoing project with my families and Clara Franchi. So this would be to realize, to ask the following question for alternating group at M for Lightship. This was done for A5. And what is remarkable is the following fact that the Lagers AM subgroup in the monster is actually A12. Right, and well, the latest result, much like the result of 2 years ago, it is based on the calculation by Clara and Margot. Well, it really says that A has Majorana representation if n less or equal to 12. So you see this condition of degree up to 12 condition has been deduced from the Majorana axioms. And well, when they performed these calculations, so they developed some interesting technique which is applicable to general theory of association skill. What is really happening? What you want is with a black matrix. So you have A tau and A, say, pi. So you take this Majorana axis, you take their inner product and form a matrix out of them. And so one of the conditions was that the, well, the inner product Majorana space is positive, definite. So this matrix have to be positive, definite. And we say this, there is a connection to the finiteness of the Coxeter group. That's what is the connection. Is when you ask about finiteness of the Coxeter group, you ask simple questions about the positive, definite. Right. So you ask about positive, definite. This, but you see. Well, we, actually, this matrix is an element of certain association scheme of the permutational module. And then, eventually, you can diagonalize these. And then, you will have, say, lambda 1, lambda 2, and lambda 3 on the element from the theorem. And then, you see, when you have the condition that lambda I should be greater than or equal to zero because of the positive definiteness. And if you want to calculate the dimension of space generated by A, you would be really interested to find in which case this lambda I is zero. I mean, what is the sort of the essence of the technique is that when you calculate this lambda sub I sort of separately, instead of taking the whole grand matrix and diagonalizing them and look at this component. So they say, well, each lambda sub I will correspond to irreducible component, a particular irreducible component of the permutation. They will ask, what is this lambda I is particular one. Anyway, so in some of particular I, they just found this will be actually 12 minus n, but on some other polynomial. So that's how this condition came about. Right, so this, how is related to the Y representation. right, so you see, if you take this longest branch of this longest stream is this diagram. So then you see that this is the Coxeter diagram of A11. Well, this A doesn't stand for alternative, this is the type of code, which is associated to it, in fact, as 12. And you see, this is 12, really the one which links the basis. Well, this is the boundary for this largest alternative content in the algebra. And in the, from the theory of Weinberg, what he said in this paper, that as long as you impose the spider relation, you can't expand further. So you can't add any generator. So if you add one more generator, the whole thing will collapse, in fact. If you put these extra generator. So somehow, in the sort of theory of Weinberg, you see that the longest simple path can be of length 11 corresponding to a 12. And from the theory of Weinberg, we also have the same bound. So, I know it's really have some sort of suggestion that maybe this, well, this Weinberg and Majorana algebra, which are certainly related to the monster, can be related independently in the sense that Weinberg is something similar to the thinking diagram for the Majorana algebra. But I think I will not go further to this so far discussion. When I proposed the title for the top of this conference, I was hoping that I will find more in this connection, but so far it's all I can say at this stage about this. And well, this is, well, you know, this philosophy really comes better when you look backwards what has been done and why it has been done, it is explained. But when you are in the business, so you just have specific questions, so well, our purpose is just to study further this Majorana algebra, so consider further different situation of generators and try to find the algebra. So this is still a lot of interesting work to be done in this triangular configuration mentioned by Madeleine is something we want to work on in the nearest future. Right. So hopefully in future we will have more to report. Thank you very much for the very stimulating.
Okay, thank you very much. Any questions? So you said that the n up to 12, an alternative group has a Majorana representation.
Yeah, but that's some specific representation. So you want to realize by Majorana, about like B transposition, for instance. And if it's B transposition, product of two transposition, and then you, well, this is, you take them as a style, and then you want to find a vector in the vector space.
So they explicitly constructed.
No, this is not, yeah. No, well, what is cool? They don't exist if n is greater or equal than 13.
Yeah.
But so far the complete classification is not yet obtained. But we know that in the monster there exists up to 12. But the complete classification.
What do you mean by complete classification of Majorana representation?
Yeah. The complete classification is still to be obtained.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, thanks. Okay, any more questions? If not, let us thank Sasha again. Okay, we now have a coffee break.